my association with the centre and the association goes back 30 years, in fact, and I was chair for many years here, and was chair during our major capital project, which transformed the centre. So I was very proud of the place, really. I've been here a long time. We are an open access community centre. We offer services, classes and events to everybody. The challenges of running a space like this, I think, are in some probably two major things. One, capital funding. You have to have that to underpin what we do. Part of, a very important part of our charitable articles, our charitable identity, means that we have to be affordable and accessible to people who, whatever activity they're engaging in at the centre. And that means affordable at the point of use. The costs have to be kept down. And costs of running a building on, you know, are significant. While we do have some reserves, we can't use all of those up just in maintaining the building. So capital funding becomes vital in maintaining that. The other thing I think is the challenge is that we are two opposite things at the same time. Because we have to be self-financing, we have to be a profitable organisation. At the same time, we have to be a full-on community representative. And those things would appear to pull in opposite directions. And they don't really, but you have to hold them together. And that's a constant, it's constant work. It doesn't go away. It's not going to come to an end at any point. You know, it's what we have to do all the time. And fortunately, we have an outstanding centre director who's able to do that. So it's always about being enterprising, finding new things to bring in, but also be conscious of the fact that we need to be a profit-making organisation. Those are the major structural challenges, I would say. The key thing was the massive capital project that we had in 2010. It took us 10 years to get there, but we won £1 million grant to build an annex. The building we're sitting in now used to be a school, primary school, with a playground at the back. So we had space and we wanted to put a new building there so that we could expand our services to the communities we work with. And in the end, we got that money, and that absolutely transformed what we did. Before we had the annex, the new part of the building put up, we were constantly having to turn people away. We just didn't have the space. So we kept a very clear record of all the business we had to turn away. So when we began the process of looking for funding to capital funding to build a new building in the space at the back, we kept a record of that. And it took us 10 years. It was a 10-year effort of everybody involved here for 10 years. We got the money in the end. And so we were able to use that capital funding to absolutely transform everything we did. We multiplied what we could offer to the community many times over. So my advice, very simply, would be know your community, and knowing your community, know what your key business is, and then focus on that and be steadfast in sticking to that. If you know what your community wants and needs and you supply it, you will always get the support, always.